William I, or in German Wilhelm I, of the House of Hohenzollern was the King of Prussia and the first German emperor, as well as the first head of state of a united Germany. Under the leadership of William and his minister-president Otto von Bismarck, Prussia achieved the unification of Germany and the establishment of the German Empire. Despite his long support of Otto von Bismarck as minister-president, however, William held strong reservations about some of Bismarck's more reactionary policies, including his anti-Catholicism and tough handling of subordinates. Contrary to the aggressive, domineering Bismarck, William was described as polite, gentlemanly, and while a staunch conservative, more open to certain classical liberal ideas than his grandson Wilhelm II. Early life and military career. The future king and emperor was born William Frederick Louis of Prussia in the Kronprinzenpalais in Berlin on 22 March 1797. As the second son of King Frederick William III and Louise of Mecklenburg-Strelitz, William was not expected to ascend to the throne. He was educated from 1801 to 1809 by Johann Friedrich Gottlieb Delbruck, who was also in charge of the education of William's brother, the Crown Prince Frederick William. At age 10, his father appointed him an officer in the Prussian army. William served in the army from 1814 onward. Like his father, he fought against Napoleon I of France during the part of the Napoleonic Wars known in Germany as the Befreiungskriege, and was reportedly a very brave soldier. He was made a captain and won the Iron Cross for his actions at Bar-sur-Aube. The war and the fight against France left a lifelong impression on him, in particular causing a long-standing antipathy against the French. In 1815, William was promoted to major and commanded a battalion of the 1st Guardy Regiment. He fought under Gebhard Leberecht von Blücher at the battles of Ligny and Waterloo. He also became an excellent diplomat by engaging in diplomatic missions after 1815. In 1816, William became the commander of the Stettiner Gardelandwehr Battalion and in 1818 was promoted to general major. The next year, William was appointed inspector of the 7th and 8th Army Corps. This made him a spokesman of the Prussian army within the House of Hohenzollern. He argued in favor of a strong, well-trained and well-equipped army. In 1820, William became commander of the 1st Guardy Division and in 1825 was promoted to commanding general of the 3rd Army Corps. In 1829, William married Princess Augusta von Saxen-Weimar-Eisenach after Princess Eliza Radziwill, his cousin whom he had been attracted to, was deemed an inappropriate match by his father. William had been forced to abandon the relationship with Eliza in 1826. Augusta was the daughter of Grand Duke Karl Friedrich von Saxen-Weimar-Eisenach. Their marriage was outwardly stable, but not a very happy one. In 1840, his older brother became King of Prussia. Since he had no children, William was first in line to succeed him to the throne and thus was given the title Prinz von Preußen. Against his convictions but out of loyalty towards his brother, in 1847 William signed the bill setting up a Prussian parliament and took a seat in the upper chamber, the Herrenhaus. During the revolutions of 1848, William successfully crushed a revolt in Berlin that was aimed at his elder brother, King Frederick William IV. The use of cannon made him unpopular at the time and earned him the nickname Kartätschen Prinz. Indeed, he had to flee to England for a while, disguised as a merchant. He returned and helped to put down an uprising in Baden, where he commanded the Prussian army. In October 1849, he became Governor-General of Rhineland and Westphalia, with a seat of the Kurfürstliches Schloss in Koblenz. During their time at Koblenz, William and his wife entertained liberal scholars like the historian Maximilian Wolfgang Duncker or August von Bethmann-Hollweg and Clemens Theodor Pertz. William's opposition to liberal ideas gradually softened. In 1854, the prince was raised to the rank of a field marshal and made governor of the federal fortress of Mainz. In 1857, Frederick William IV suffered a stroke and became mentally disabled for the rest of his life. In January 1858, William became Prince Regent for his brother, initially only temporarily but after October on a permanent basis. Against the advice of his brother, William swore an oath of office on the Prussian constitution and promised to preserve it, solid and inviolable. William appointed a liberal, Karl Anton von Hohenzollern Sigmaringen, as minister-president and thus initiated what became known as the New Era in Prussia. Although there were conflicts between William and the liberal majority in the Landtag on matters of reforming the armed forces, King. On 2 January 1861, Frederick William died and William ascended the throne as William I of Prussia. In July, a student from Leipzig tried to assassinate William, but he was only lightly injured. Like Frederick I of Prussia, William traveled to Königsberg and there crowned himself at the Schloss Gisch. William chose the anniversary of the Battle of Leipzig, the 18th of October, for this event, which was the first Prussian crowning ceremony since 1701 and the only crowning of a German king in the 19th century. William refused to comply with his brother's wish, expressed in Frederick William's last will, that he should abrogate the constitution. William inherited a conflict between Frederick William and the liberal Landtag. He was considered a politically neutral person as he intervened less in politics than his brother. In 1862, the Landtag refused an increase in the military budget that was required to pay for the already implemented reform of the army. This involved raising the peacetime army from 150,000 to 200,000 men and boost the annual number of new recruits from 40,000 to 63,000. However, the truly controversial part was the plan to keep the length of military service at 3 years, when his request backed by his Minister of War Albrecht von Roon was refused. William first considered resigning, but his son, the Crown Prince, advised strongly against it. Then, on the advice of Roon, William appointed Otto von Bismarck to the office of minister-president in order to force through the proposals. According to the Prussian constitution, the minister-president was responsible solely to the king, not to the Landtag. Bismarck, a conservative Prussian junker and loyal friend of the king, liked to see his working relationship with William as that of a vassal to his feudal superior. Nonetheless, it was Bismarck who effectively directed the politics, domestic as well as foreign. On several occasions he gained William's assent by threatening to resign. During his reign, William was the commander-in-chief of the Prussian forces in the Second Schleswig War against Denmark in 1864 and the Austro-Prussian War in 1866. After the latter was won by Prussia, William wanted to march on to Vienna and annex Austria, but Bismarck and Crown Prince Frederick talked him out of it. Bismarck wanted to end the war, so as to allow Prussia to ally with Austria if it needed to at a later date. Frederick was also appalled by the casualties and wanted a speedy end to hostilities. During a heated discussion, Bismarck threatened to resign if William continued to Vienna. Bismarck got his way. In 1867, the North German Confederation was created and William became its president. In 1870, during the Franco-Prussian War, William was in command of all the German forces at the crucial Battle of Sedan. Emperor. During the Franco-Prussian War, on 18 January 1871 in the Hall of Mirrors in Versailles Palace, William was proclaimed German Emperor. The title, German Emperor, was carefully chosen by Bismarck after discussion until the day of the proclamation. William accepted this title grudgingly as he would have preferred Emperor of Germany, which, however, was unacceptable to the federated monarchs, and would also have signaled a claim to lands outside his realm. The title, Emperor of the Germans, as proposed in 1848, was ruled out as he considered himself chosen by the grace of God, not by the people as in a republic. William's brother Frederick William IV had been elected Emperor of the Germans by the Frankfurt National Assembly on 28 March 1849, but then refused the crown already on 3 April 1849, purportedly saying that he would not accept a crown from the gutter. William also viewed his kingship of Prussia as much more important than the title of German Emperor. He complained to his son, Crown Prince Frederick, about having to exchange the radiant Prussian crown for this filth crown. By this ceremony, the North German Confederation was transformed into the German Empire. This empire was a federal state, the emperor was head of state and president of the federated monarchs. In 1872 he arbitrated a boundary dispute between Great Britain and the United States, deciding in favor of the U.S., and placing the San Juan Islands of Washington State within U.S. national territory, thus ending the 12-year bloodless pig war. In his memoirs, Bismarck describes William as an old-fashioned, courteous, infallibly polite gentleman and a genuine Prussian officer, whose good common sense was occasionally undermined by female influences. This was a reference to William's wife, who had been educated by, among others, Johann Wolfgang von Goethe and was intellectually superior to her husband. She was also at times very outspoken in her opposition to official policies as she was a liberal. William, however, had long been strongly opposed to liberal ideas. Despite possessing considerable power as Kaiser, William left the task of governing mostly to his chancellor and limited himself to representation, embodying the dignity of the state and approving Bismarck's policies. Assassination attempts and anti-socialist laws. On the 11th of May 1878, a plumber named Emil Max Hodel failed in an assassination attempt on William in Berlin. Hodel used a revolver to shoot at the emperor, while the 81-year-old and his daughter, Princess Louise of Prussia, paraded in their carriage unter den Linden. When the bullet missed, Hodel ran across the street and fired another round, which also missed. In the commotion, one of the individuals who tried to apprehend Hodel suffered severe internal injuries and died 2 days later. The state convicted Hodel after a photographer who took the radical's picture days before the assassination attempt testified that after he took the picture, Hodel said it would sell thousands once a certain piece of information was hashed through the world. Hodel was beheaded on the 16th of August 1878. A second attempt to assassinate William I was made on 2 June 1878 by Dr. Karl Nobiling. As the emperor drove past in an open carriage, the assassin fired 2 shots from a shotgun at him from the window of a house off the Unter den Linden. William was severely wounded and was rushed back to the palace, and Nobiling shot himself in an attempt to commit suicide. While William survived this attack, the assassin died from his self-inflicted wound 3 months later. Despite the fact that Hodel had been expelled from the Social Democratic Party, his actions were used as a pretext by Bismarck to ban the party through the anti-socialist law in October 1878. To do this, Bismarck partnered with Ludwig Bamberger, a liberal, who had written on the subject of socialism, "If I don't want any chickens, then I must smash the eggs." No one in the Social Democratic Party even knew of Karl Nobiling. But that is not to say that he was not politically motivated. These attempts on William's life thus became the pretext for the institution of the anti-socialist law, which was introduced by Bismarck's government with the support of a majority in the Reichstag on 18 October 1878, for the purpose of fighting the socialist and working class movement. The laws deprived the Social Democratic Party of Germany of its legal status. They prohibited all organizations, workers' mass organizations and the socialist and workers' press, decreed confiscation of socialist literature, and subjected Social Democrats to reprisals. The laws were extended every 2 to 3 years. Despite this policy of reprisals, the Social Democratic Party increased its influence among the masses. Under pressure of the mass working class movement, the laws were repealed on 1 October 1890. Later years and death. In August 1878, Russian Tsar Alexander II, William's nephew, wrote a letter to him complaining about the treatment Russian interests had received at the Congress of Berlin. In response, William, his son, the Crown Prince, and his wife Augusta traveled to Russia to mend fences in face-to-face talks. However, by once again threatening to resign, Bismarck overcame the opposition of William to a closer alliance with Austria. In October, William agreed to the Zweibund between Germany and Austria-Hungary, which was directed against Russia. Another assassination attempt failed on 18 September 1883 when William unveiled the Niederwald-Denkmal in Rüdesheim. A group of anarchists had prepared an attack using dynamite, which failed due to the wet weather. Despite the assassination attempts and William's unpopular role in the 1848 uprising, he and his wife were very popular, especially in their later years. Many people considered him the personification of the old Prussia, and liked their austere and simple lifestyle. William died on 9 March 1888 in Berlin after a short illness. He was buried on 16 March at the mausoleum at Park Charlottenburg. To honor him, a large number of memorials, statues were erected all over the country over the following years. The best known among them are the Kufhauser Monument in Thuringia, the monument at Porta Westfalica, and the mounted statue of William at the Deutsches Eck in Koblenz. The statue next to the Stadtschloss Berlin was melted down by the communist rulers of East Berlin in 1950. From 1867 to 1918, more than 1,000 memorials to William I were constructed. Issue. William and Augusta of Saxe-Weimar had two children, Frederick III, German Emperor, and Princess Louise of Prussia. Titles, styles, honors and arms. Titles and styles. The 22nd of March 1797 to 2 January 1861. His Royal Highness Prince William of Prussia, the 2nd of January 1861 to 18 January 1871. His Majesty the King of Prussia, the 18th of January 1871 to 9 March 1888. His Imperial and Royal Majesty the German Emperor, King of Prussia, full title as German Emperor. His Imperial and Royal Majesty William I, by the grace of God, German Emperor and King of Prussia, Margrave of Brandenburg, Burgrave of Nuremberg, Count of Hohenzollern, Sovereign and Supreme Duke of Silesia and of the County of Glatz, Grand Duke of the Lower Rhine and of Posen, Duke of Saxony, of Westphalia, of Angria, of Pomerania, Lüneburg, Holstein and Schleswig, of Magdeburg, of Bremen, of Gelders, Cleves, Jülichenburg, Duke of the Wends and the Kasubs, of Crossen, Lauenburg and Mecklenburg, Landgrave of Hessen-Thuringia, Margrave of Upper and Lower Sarsia, Prince of Orange, Prince of Rügen, of East Friesland, of Paderborn and Piemont, of Halberstadt, Münster, Minden, Osnabrück, Hildesheim, of Verden, Kamen, Fulda, Nassau and Moers, Princely Count of Henneberg, Count of Mark, of Ravensburg, of Hohenstein, Tecklenburg and Lingen, of Mansfeld, Sigmaringen and Veringen, Lord of Frankfurt. Ancestry.